We're live at the Ottawa Food Bank today, and I'll tell you what, it's time for a little tour of this facility. And I tell you why we're doing this. We've been coming here for years now, and it looked a whole lot different when I walked in this morning. Gary McCarthy is with me. What are your warehouse manager, is that it, Gary?
Operations manager.
Operations manager, and how long have you been doing that?
I've been here 16 years.
Is that right?
After I retired from the federal government.
So you were a federal government employee, you retired.
Yeah, after and then 31 years.
You decided to come on over and help out at the food bank.
Yeah, I started a week after retirement and got bored and came here.
Were you a volunteer at first?
Or? I was for the first year. I was driving and delivering the food.
And then it ended up being a full-time.
Yes, amazing how things turn out, so yeah.
We're in the original space right now, right?
Right, yeah, this is our original 10,000 square feet.
Right.
This side basically is all a receiving of donated food.
Right, sorting of food is over there. Yeah,
sorting over there by volunteers. We rely heavily on volunteers.
Right.
Very generous. So everything that comes in here is sorted.
Right.
And then inventoried.
There's a rope here. What happens if I pull that?
That's for our nice fridge. So quite a few people aren't aware that we also take perishables.
Right. So usually we ask for non-perishable food items, but people can donate the perishable items as well?
Oh, yeah. Any perishables, fruit, vegetables. We have the milk that's donated by the dairy farmers.
Right, right.
Eggs.
Bread isn't in here, but it's one of those perishable items. I know you get that donated nicely, too.
Weston and Dempster's donates a terrific amount of bread.
What about meat and stuff like that, like protein items?
Yeah, out here we have two freezers, two walk-in freezers.
Is that right? So you do take that stuff as well?
Yeah, any frozen goods.
Right.
We also have a food aid program where we actually purchase four cows every Monday morning.
Is that right?
From the livestock barn in Greeley.
No kidding.
And it's all transformed into nice ground beef.
Right. Which, let's head over this way, because this is a newer part of the facility, right?
Yeah, this is the part we took over the middle of June.
Right. And did you actually purchase this building?
No, we just
leased it. You rent it? You lease it?
But our landlord has been very, very generous.
Is that right?
He's given us a terrific deal on per square foot.
So how much more square footage do you have?
It's an additional 10, so we're up to 19,000 square feet.
What comes in here?
This is all the food that's inventoried.
Right.
So all the donated food comes in here.
And everything, this is where all the sorted stuff ends up?
Right.
Okay.
Once it's scanned and put into inventory.
And you have a new scanning system, I know that too.
Yeah,
right?
We just started that. So everything's immediately received on the scanner input.
Now, the shelves in here look pretty full at the moment. Is that a fair assessment?
Yeah, they are, and that's thanks to our recent...
The food drives, the OC Transpo one.
The Thanksgiving food drive, the OC Transpo.
And ours just came
and
in.
And yours, which was just absolutely fantastic this year.
Yeah, I think we're going to be... I don't want to give anything away, and I don't even want to know, but I heard rumors that we got a really good total this year, and we're pretty happy about that. Once people start coming in, though, this place empties out pretty quick.
It does. So we actually have to purchase a fair amount of food every year to keep up with the demand.
Right.
And we actually purchase well over $1 million
in
a year. Yeah.
Is that
right?
And
that's taken, from the financial donations we get.
Exactly.
So that's to keep up with the with the demand. And, we're now have over 48,000 people a month that rely on food assistance.
Does it ever shock you, that number, Gary? I know you're used to it. You've been here a long time. But that seems like a really large number to me.
It is, and the sad part is that it's forever increasing.
Yeah.
A lot
it
of it now is with the working poor, that we say working poor. So people that do have full-time jobs, but it's the minimum wage.
Yeah, they're paying their rent, their heat, and then they just don't have enough left over. Yeah,
especially in the winter months.
Is that right?
That's when they get their heating bills. And so we see an increase during the winter months for sure.
I'll tell you what, it's a fabulous facility you run here. It unfortunately, it had to get bigger because of the demand that you do have, but we appreciate what you do, and I want to thank you for the tour.
Oh, well,
thank you for all your good work.
CTV for that.
Well, you know what? It's fun coming over to see you guys every year. We love doing it. There's no question about it. It's one of our favorite shows of the year.
We also look forward to it.
All right, buddy. Good to see you.